And in terms of the forensics, how do you decide what to do to find out if you have been taken advantage of? And anybody who wants to answer, just chime right out.
This is Jim. Having served as an in-house counsel, I could tell you that there are a couple of things you have to put into place first. You have to make sure that, number one, you have the ability to check what your employees are doing, whether that be a keystroke program on their computers or access to their system, making sure that anytime there's a flash drive inserted into the computer or anytime an email is outbound, you want to be able to review that. So there are a lot of things that you need to put into place from a company-wide standpoint to assist you in doing the correct forensics. Assuming you haven't done that, there are still some other things that you can do. For example, most companies nowadays use laptops, which they assign to their employees. Always isolate the laptop, always isolate the hard drive, mirror it, or I call it ghosting it, and save a copy of it, go through it, do a forensic analysis of the hard drive. You want to maintain and keep the mirrored image pristine so as to ensure that that's not accessed at all, while you then go through the hard drive to see if there have been any insertions of flash drives or jump drives. You want to be able to see what has been transferred or downloaded in terms of information from the server or emails that have been sent out. Those are the first things that you'll do. If in fact it's a company phone, you'll do the same thing with the company phone. You also want to watch out for a couple of things that are really on the cutting edge, and that is, did the employee, and this happens a lot with salespeople, did the employee, prior to the time they left, within a short period of time prior to the time they left, go ahead and sign up for, say, LinkedIn or Facebook or some other social media platform? For example, in LinkedIn, you can upload all of your contacts to your LinkedIn profile, which then makes it public. And then the employee, after they leave your employment, can go ahead and contact those same contacts that are on their LinkedIn. Now, if they do it correctly, most states say that they can do what's called a wedding announcement of a transition from company A to company B. But if they're going ahead and soliciting each of the individual people on their contact list, then it may be the subject of a violation of a non-compete. Or if you're in a state that you can make the claim that a theft of customer lists is a violation of either the UTSA or DTSA, then in fact you can proceed in that fashion. So those are just a couple of things that you want to do. And oh, by the way, you do want to modify your handbook to ensure that you have a right to do these, although most states will allow you to do these steps anyway, but I would still put it in an employee handbook.